Hey y'all, it's Kosta. I help people break the system to build a better future. Today, we're talking about what happens when we run out of long-term care workers. I've worked in long-term care for the past decade, and if you've watched any of my previous videos, you know one of the greatest obstacles facing our industry is workforce availability and the shrinking numbers of caregivers in this country. Last week, Governor Tim Walz of Minnesota announced that he was activating the Minnesota National Guard to form skilled nursing response teams to support long-term care facilities dealing with staffing shortages. The direction comes as the state continues to have hospital capacity concerns due to a surge in COVID-19. And just a week later, the governor's office announced Minnesota would receive 2 emergency federal medical teams to help treat patients. A total of 400 Guards members will start training as certified nursing assistants and temporary nursing aides over the next week, according to the governor's office. Skilled nursing facilities facing severe staffing shortages can request help from the Minnesota Department of Health, and facilities that are selected will get a guard team to provide on-site staffing support for up to 3 weeks at a time. Just a crazy world, guys. I mean, crazy. Walz also announced plans to recruit and train an additional 1,000 certified nursing assistants to send to long-term care facilities by the end of January 2022. So when our access to caregivers diminishes to the point of calling the National Guard to remedy the issue, guys, that's a problem. In the long-term care industry, we depend on our workforce to keep the industry alive and keep our most vulnerable loved ones alive. I've talked in many videos about what we can do to start fixing the problem, but if you look at the numbers for both our aging population and access to resource for care, the math just does not add up. Is deploying the National Guard and utilizing our military for long-term care really the best use of their talent and skills? I mean, really? If we can't stabilize our workforce and gain control over our public health, we might not have another choice. And running out of choices is not a place that any of us want to be.